Good evening, everybody. I've got a couple of things I want to talk about tonight, but I think the biggest thing I wanted to focus on was one particular thing. What I really want is that's, by the way, that's girl. Just wanted to do a quick photo of her. Hey, everybody, it's Jeff of Solid Canine Training, and hey, Linda, how are you? I love you. And there's one thing I really wanted to focus on. I'm going to start doing these mini Periscopes just because I've got all these things on my mind, and I think they're really, really helpful for people. I want to know what are people's fears with their own dog? So I'm not talking about a dog trainer. I'm talking about you and your own dog. What are you afraid to do with your own dog, even though you know it will most likely make it better for your dog? In other words, your dog will be better behaved. You'll have a better relationship with your dog, but for some reason, you just can't do it. You just can't do it. Have her free with another dog. Well, that's a different story because if your dog's aggressive, then it might go shit way wrong. But we have protocols for that. We have protocols for that. So is the reason why you're afraid to be your dog is leash aggressive? Well, just to give you a heads up on leash aggression. Leash aggressive or leash reactive. Leash aggressive or leash reactive, there's a big difference. So a leash reactive dog is not necessarily an aggressive dog. It's just badly behaved. So you can actually fix that. Crate him at night. Yeah, that's a big thing. That's a huge thing for a lot of folks is when you crate your dog at night. And even though it's been crated all day long, so you feel guilty. You feel guilty. But this is the thing. You've got to work, right? You've got to work. You've got to have a job. And the dog's sleeping anyway, because the crating is more of a leadership thing than anything else. The crating is a leadership skill more than anything else. So I think it's important that people, I'm a huge advocate of containment. Now, if your dog has got zero behavior problems, it's not resource guarding, it's not aggressive towards dogs or people, it doesn't have separation anxiety, then fine. You can just maybe just not do the crate, not do the crate. Well, for correcting for lunging, this is what I want you to do. What I want you to do is I actually want you to put a piece of tape. Not clear Scotch tape, right? Some masking tape or electrical tape or gaffer's tape over the numbers. And I want you to use that remote until the dog stops. When the dog though is you're afraid to go high, stop looking at as that as a number and look at it as information. Does that make sense? Look at it as information because what you're doing is you're underwhelming your dog. You're nagging your dog. And I know you don't want to be a nag. My mother used to nag me. I hated it. I hated it. So if you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gelman, Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training. And I really want to just focus on one topic at a time. And it's what are you afraid of? That you know will help your dog. Is it okay if he yelps? It is okay if he yelps. It is okay. The thing is, you most likely startled your dog. Your dog was going, "What the heck was that?" The bottom line is this: if you're struggling with a behavior, and we know that a 1 or 2 or 3 second stim on the remote can help you with that behavior and fix that behavior, say your dog does yelp, it's okay. It's okay. Don't look at the yelp as being harmful or abusive. Just don't do that. Who here has never gotten a sports massage? When I get my sports massage, the sounds that you'd think there was lovemaking going on in that massage room. You'd think that I was in massive pain. I'm going, oh yeah, And my sports massage guy is going, "Jeff, are you okay?" And I'm like, "Oh yeah, keep going at it, keep going at it." Because it's helping me. It's helping me. So don't be misled by the yelp. Don't be misled by the yelp. Taking your dog off leash in your neighborhood, That could be scary for the first time. What I suggest you do is have your dog drag the leash. Have your dog drag the leash and then do lots and lots of recall. Lots of recall. How do I know when he's ready for an off-leash walk? Proof it, but have him on a leash dragging. So remote collar with a leash dragging. That's what I would do. That's what we do. That's what we do. Because you want to have that safety net. You want to have that safety net. You also want to be making a bunch of turns. So you're walking, heel, boom, turn right, turn left into the dog, come to a stop, sit the dog, down the dog, heel the dog, do a lot of quick. Girl, you're freaking out over here. Come here, girl. These commands are not for you. Plots. Good girl. You know. Okay. So, you know, that can be scary. When you're taking your dog off leash, it can be scary. But what I want you to do is proof it on a long line. That's what I want you to do. There's a little character in the corner. Click on that character. Share this on your Facebook page. Share this on Twitter. Share this on Periscope. Make sure you start liking me on all my different social media platforms as well. All right? So the topic of tonight is, this is about your personal dog. What are you afraid to do, even though you know it will make your dog's behavior better? So you want to do it. You want to do it, but you don't do it. But you want to do it because you know it'll make it better. What is it? It's fear. What's holding you back, and how can I help you get over that? How can I help you get over that? Too high of a correction? Yeah, I mean, we're all afraid of giving too high, but you know what? I'm going to tell you, most owners underwhelm their dogs. They really do. They really do. Read the dog. Read the dog. You know, read the dog. Pay attention to the dog. Don't worry about the numbers. Stop looking at your numbers and pay attention to your dog. When you start paying attention to the dog, what you do... Oh, good. I'm glad you like this subject. Good. It's been on my mind for a while. This is what I'm doing is... what are your thoughts on I don't have a problem with using remote collar for socialization if it's used as like an interrupter / corrector. I don't have a problem. I want your dog to be remote collar trained though before you do that. Remember, folks, a remote collar is a communication device. You got over your, oh my gosh, I'm so proud of you. Mama Hans, you walked two of your dogs together. I'm so, so proud of you. That's fantastic. What a big accomplishment. Did you walk them on either side of you? Did you have like one dog on each side? Because that's a great way to start. If anybody's struggling with their dogs, like how to walk their dogs together, putting one on each side is a great way to start. Good for you. I'm really proud of you. Keep it tight. Don't put up with any nonsense at all. Keep it tight. Don't put up with any nonsense at all. That's the best thing to do. Wow. Same side? That's impressive. That's impressive. Good for you. I'm really proud of you. You've come, Mama Hans, you've come such a long way. This is what I really like about social media. And this is what I really like about Periscope and all this free content that myself and a lot of my fellow trainers are putting out. People are learning and it's being helpful. You know, people are learning and it's being helpful. How awesome is this? This is fantastic. This is fantastic. Good for you. So I'm in New Orleans right now. I'm in Sean's loft. You did a scope of trick training. Did you do it with Morgan? Did you do your own periscope of trick training? You're doing your own scopes now, Mama Hans? That's awesome. That's great. I'm in here in New Orleans right now. We're going to be going out later tonight. It's Mardi Gras. There might be a little bit of debauchery. How do you pronounce that? Debauchery? Debauchery? There might be some debauchery. I've got some three heavily debaucherous people sitting next to me. And Sean's coming in from the airport right now. And I found a great place to park the RV right out in front. Good for you. That's excellent. Yeah, Morgan's a great trick trainer. She's a great trainer in general, but she does the Tuesday trick training on Red Mark Kennels. Go to Red Mark Kennels. It's fantastic. It's a great time. So yeah, I'm just getting ready to go out. Debauchery with a Boston accent. Debauchery. debauchery. Yeah. Debaucheros. Who said that? No, you're way, I think you're way off on that one. You're way off on that one. But we're going to be here in New Orleans, and I'm going to be periscoping from Mardi Gras, so we'll be having a lot of good times. Yeah, so if you've got a dog that attacks, that used to be friendly, and then he got attacked, what your dog is doing is your dog is fighting first. Your dog is fighting. Where are we going to go tonight? We'll probably go, where are we going tonight, Morgan? Anywhere special? Nowhere special, probably in the neighborhood. We probably won't go into the war zone tonight. We're probably going to stick around into the neighborhood. So there's going to be no boobalicious fun tonight. I think what we're going to do is we'll probably just, I know what will happen is we'll walk downstairs. Sean will probably go to, what's that bar called? The Friendly? Friendlies?
Friendly Bar.
The Friendly Bar? Sean might go into the Friendly Bar and get like a nickel drink. They've got drinks for a nickel there. So, oh, you're going to be at the RV in March? Good. Yeah, Sean just landed about 15 minutes ago. Now we'll take a taxi. Taxi takes about, what, half an hour to get here. But what you're doing is you're, Sean has, how many bags does he have with his shoes? Like five bags? Sean has like four or five bags. He usually has to take two taxi cabs here, one for his luggage and one for him. So unless they have a minivan available, if they've got a minivan available, he'll be able to do it. And Brittany's husband is here, too. Brittany's husband is here. So it's, oh, it's going to be three boys and three girls. One, two, three. Oh, it's going to be three boys and two girls. It's going to be three boys and two girls tonight. I can't count. And I'll probably take girl with me, too, because she needs to get out and exercise. Or maybe not. Maybe I'll just leave her in the RV. She loves the RV. That's where she's the most comfortable. So what else do we got here? Who else is struggling? Yes, I'm going to interview Laura again. I'm going to do another interview with Laura. Yep, she's been on pins and needles. She's asking me every 5 minutes when I'm going to do another interview with her. Yep, she can't wait. She can't wait. She can't wait. Yep, don't worry, Raquel. It's all about you, Raquel. It's all about you. Laura is fantastic. Yes, she is. Laura is an incredibly special, special person. The boonies are showing all the, or the boobies are showing all the time on Bourbon Street. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of nonsense going on tonight. But I can't wait to see the live music. The music that you see in the streets are the best. Letting your dog off leash is the first tips. Make sure your dog is remote collar trained, number one. Make sure your dog is remote collar trained. And then I want your dog on a long line and make sure you've got that recall. I want your dog turning on a dime. Turning on a dime, meaning every time you say the word here, your dog spins around. Tomorrow morning, I'll do where I park the RV, there's a big field across the street that says no trespassing. So I'll be in that field doing work. And what I'll do is I'll show you some tips on when do you know your dog's ready to be off leash. Oh, Raquel, I'm glad you're having good information on the long. Yep. Yep. I would just do the remote. Remote collars are great for getting dogs off the smells. Oh, you're welcome, Raquel. Yeah, Sean and myself and Laura really like working with you. So, and I was just talking to Laura about your website tonight. And, oh, you got an email already. Good. 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 So, oh, I'm glad I was able to help you with your Doberman. You're worried about squirrels? Well, what you're going to do is you proof your dog with squirrels. With squirrels, you're just going to have to go up higher on the level. And what I want, she's not mad. Dogs don't get mad at squirrels. They hate their guts, but they don't get mad at them. There's a huge difference. So don't, if your dog focuses on a squirrel, you know what you tell your dog? Knock it off. She's not on an e-collar. Why aren't you putting your dog on an e-collar? Put your dog on an e-collar. It's so much fun. You're not mad crazy for it? Okay, let's do this. Let's think logically. Oh, you want to think logically? Let's think logically. Ready? Dog goes after a squirrel and gets hit by a car and dies. Dog is remote collar trained and ignores the squirrel. Which one would you rather have? Remote collar trained. Remote collar trained. So I like e-collar technologies. Get the mini educator. get the mini educator, ecower.com. Tell them Jeff sent you. I don't make anything off of it, but just tell them I sent you. Start ecower. Okay, let me see. Who is that? Can you, whoever is afraid of ecowers, can you drive a car? Can you drive a car? Answer the question. No Fifth Amendment bullshit here. Can you drive a car? Yes or no? Yes, okay. If you can drive a car, you can use a remote car. She's 10 pounds and my trainer said, don't. Okay, well then this is what I want you to do. I want you to have that trainer go to a field with a bunch of squirrels and recall the dog. That's what I want you to do. I want you to listen to your trainer. If your trainer cannot recall your dog off squirrels, I want you to find a new trainer. Okay? It's a simple concept, right? It's a simple concept. If I hired a personal trainer and I gained 5 pounds a week, I would tell the trainer to go fuck himself. But I want a trainer to help me. So that's what I would do. But you don't have to, you know, you don't have to use a remote collar, but unfortunately then you're going to be limited on your, you're probably limited on your results. Yep. If you've been wanting to do it, this is what I would do. Myself and Sean O'Shea. Sean O'Shea has a great video right now. You can get it online. Go to his website, thegooddog.net, thegooddog.net. I actually own thegooddog.com and I'm not going to sell it to him. So go to thegooddog.net and you can get his online version of his remote collar video. And I'm telling you, it's easier than making souffle. It's easier than making quiche. It's easier than driving a car. It's easier than making toast. I'm telling you, remote collar training is easy to do. It really, really is. So go get one. And you're not going to F up your dog. You really won't. You won't. Love it. Love it. If you can drive and text, you can use a remote collar. And we all drive and text. Right? With some breeds, with all breeds. I mean, just think about it. Remote collar training, it's a lot of times people think, well, remote collars are not for every dog. I'm actually going to disagree with that. That's like saying training is not for every dog. All a remote collar is a communication device that I can whisper and shout up to a mile away. That's all it is. I can break through all the nonsense of distractions. You know, that's all that is. It really is. So what else is everybody struggling with? Well, unfortunately, the remote collar on a 7-pound dog, a 5-pound dog is a little bit challenging. So that can be a little bit challenging. And remember, you don't have to put the remote collar on the dog on a Monday and then take it out off leash on a Wednesday. It's training. It's training. It's a protocol. And prong collars, you don't have to use a prong collar if you don't want to. You don't have to use any of these tools if you don't want to. That's the thing about dog training. Nobody's holding a gun to your head. It's all based on personal choice. But, you know, all the people sitting in this room right now are huge advocates of tools because we want to help. We don't want to see you struggle anymore. You know what I mean? We don't want to see you struggle. Yeah, e-collar is great. E-collar is great. Remember, 90% of the information out there about remote collars is outright blatant lie. Some of it's unethical. And if a vet lies about an e-collar, they actually should be disbarred, in my opinion. You know, imagine this. If a vet says e-collars burn dogs, that's like a vet saying that eating out of a stainless steel bowl causes cancer. Think about that. The vet is lying to you and they should be disbarred. Any vet that has a medical degree with a certificate on the wall that went to a university that says that remote collars burn dogs should immediately be disbarred because they have lied to you, their client. They're giving you false information that has never been documented in the world. So they're lying to you. They're lying to you. They're not using fact. They're not using fact at all. Yeah, the e-collar, meaning the e-collars are coming out with a smaller one as well. Yeah, the little dog one, that's the hard one. The mini educators are the smallest ones they make right now. Greg is going to be making a smaller one. No, you don't have to wait. You can get going on it right now. You can always sell your old e-collar too. 10-pound Bichon can use a remote collar. They really can. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Okay? All right. All right, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to close this up. I don't use the tone, no. Yep. All right, I'm going to close this up right now. My name is Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training. I'm madly in love with you. Let's remember, let's hug our children, let's train our dogs, and I'm madly in love with you. And I'll be seeing everybody really, really soon, okay? All right. Thank you so much.